हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। सो एज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड एक्सरसाइज 2.3 इन आवर प्रीवियस सेशन, इन दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चंस और द इक्वेशंस विथ मोर देन टू टू थ्री टर्म्स बोथ इन लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड राइट हैंड साइड। इन दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एडिटिव इनवर्स, मल्टीप्लीकेटिव इनवर्स, फाइंडिंग द वेरिएबल्स। ओके, so now in this session we will be going to learn about I have told you about the angle sum properties of the parallel lines, isn't it? Transversal, and I have already told about the triangles, isn't it? Now coming to example number 13, you can see in the example number 13, so here I have a diagram. So here I have two lines parallel to each other, that is L and M, and here I have point A, B, C, D. This is the transversal, isn't it? This is the transversal. This is 5x, and here we have 2x plus 24 degree. And the points mentioned are, here it is E, here it is F, here it is G. Okay, so here we have G. So let me, read the question once. Question number, example number 13. In the figure, L is parallel to M. P, a transversal, find the value of X. P is a transversal. What we need to do? We need to find the value of X. So here it is P. P is a line transversal. Okay. Here it is H. This line is. Okay. So this how we have, he had given. Here we have two parallel lines. And this is called as transversal. As I have told in our previous class, I have already explained you about the transversal adjacent interior. Am I right? So this is how he had given in the question, and what he asked? He asked to find the angle of X here. What is the value of X? He asked. You already know about this. If this is 5x, this is also 5x. Am I right? If this is 5x, this is also 5x. It means that these both the values are equal. These are called as corresponding angles. What do we call that? Corresponding angles. Okay. So you see here, these two angles are equal, these two angles are equal, this is equal, as we have discussed in previous class. Again, this is 5x, this is also 5x. If this is 5x, this is also 5x, alternate interior angles. Directly, if I take the connection in between these are called as corresponding angles. What do you call that? Corresponding angles. So here, by the corresponding angle, these both the values are equal. Both the values are equal, so directly you can find the value of X. Okay, now let me tell you what he had given. Given L parallel to M, this line L is parallel to M, and P is transversal. What is P? P is a transversal. What he had given the angles? EFB. Angle EFB is equals to 5x, and similarly angle FGD is equals to 2x plus 24 whole degree. What do we know from angle sum properties? What? Corresponding angles. These both the angles are equal. So since angle EFB is equals to angle FGD, why? Corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles, it means that these both the values are equal. That is, 5x value is equals to 2x plus 24 degree. Now I have to take the like terms at one side. This is smaller, isn't it? So I have to take this in left hand side. How I will take? And directly I can't. I have to use additive inverse of plus 2x, that is minus 2x. So subtract 2x on both sides. So 5x minus 2x is equals to 2x minus 2x plus 24 degree. Am I right? So plus 2x and minus 2x will become 0. So these both are like terms. 5x minus 2x, how much will get? 3x is equals to 24 degree. Am I right? 24 degree. Now here 3 is multiplying the variable, so you have to use multiplicative inverse of 3, that is 1 by 3. It means that it is multiplying, we need to divide. So divide 3 on both sides, divide 3 on both sides. So we'll get 3x divided by 3 equals to 24 divided by 3. 3 by 3 is 1 and 24 by 3, 3 8s are 24. Am I right? So x is equals to 24, 3 8s are, isn't it? So if you divide 24 by 3, you will be getting the value as 8. So this is how you will find the values of x whenever it is given in a form of angle sum properties. You can see here, we have already discussed about this angle sum properties. Am I right? What are these both? These both are vertically opposite angles. These both are also vertically opposite angles. If I am taking here alternate interior angles, these all are alternate exterior angles. Same side, they are lying upside. So this is called as corresponding angles. If they are lying like this, here we have the angle, then these both the conditions, these are called as co-interior angles, isn't it? We have already discussed when we are been discussing about the triangles, isn't it? About the transversal, we have already discussed in our previous class. Am I right? So this is how you will find the value of x whenever it is being given in a form of diagrammatical way, that is in a form of parallel lines and transversal. Okay, now coming to next one, you can see example number here. I have example number 14. What question he had given in the book? See here what he asked in the example number 14. So I'm not writing the whole question. Here again we have got word problems. Okay, in this you can see Hema is 24 years older than her daughter Damini. So totally here we are having two persons. Who are those? First one is Hema and second one is Damini. So I have already told you to convert this in an easiest form. What we will do? We'll be drawing a table. So from this tabular way, we can easily, okay, solve any type of questions. Okay. So here we are taking names. First one, Hema. And second, we have Damini. Damini. You can see Hema is 24 years older than her daughter Damini. It means that daughter is Damini and Damini's mother is Hema, isn't it? So what is he had given? Okay, so Damini and Hema. 6 years ago, Hema was thrice old as Damini. Find the present age. The whole thing is given in a terms of Damini. So first we are taking the name of Damini and later we are taking Hema. Understood? Why we are taking Damini first? Why? Because her mother's age is been depending upon Damini. So here I am taking that age as x. So here I am writing present age. What is the present age of Damini? Let us take that as x. So what is Hema is 24 older than her daughter Damini and 6 years ago. Now my age is 25 years. What was my age before 5 years? Now I am 25. Before 5 years, my age was 20 years ago, what we will do? We will subtract, isn't it? So 5, how many years? 6 years ago. This word is very, very important. After and ago. Ago means before. So if we are going before, we are just subtracting. And if we are going after, then we are adding. So what her present age is X. Before 6 years, what is her age? X minus 6. Am I right? Dhamini's age, presently I am taking the Dhamini's age as X, isn't it? What was her age before 6 years is X minus 6. Now coming to Hema, okay, Hema is 25 years older than her daughter. It means that if Dhamini's age is X, then her mother is 24 years more than Dhamini. If Dhamini is of 10 years, what is her mother's age? She is 34 years older. Why? Why? Because the difference between Hema and Dhamini is 24. It means Hema is 24 years elder than Dhamini. Am I right? So now, what about before? Okay, before, we are discussing about before 6 years, na? So what her age becomes? X plus 24 minus 6, am I right? So what we are doing? We are just subtracting. Before, present age of Dhamini is X. Her mother is X plus 24. Why? She is 24 years bigger than Dhamini. So plus 24. Now, age ago, 6 years ago, that is before 6 years, her age will become X minus 6. Similarly, Hema's age will become X plus 24 minus 6. Why I have taken? X plus 4 is 20, present age of the Hema before 6 years. It means I have to remove minus 6. So what I will get? X plus 24 minus 6 is 18. Am I right? So this is how we will find the age before 6 years of, before 6 years, age of Dhamini is X minus 6 and age of Hema is X plus 18. Now coming to next point, 6 years ago, Hema was thrice as old as Dhamini. This point is important, okay? 6 years ago, Hema was thrice as old as Dhamini. You can see here, he had given the age before, he had given the word, this word problem in before, depending upon before 6 years. So what he said? Before 6 years, Hema was thrice, that is 3 times older than Dhamini. 3 times. So he is discussing about 3 years ago. So we need to take this line, isn't it? 3 years ago. So what is Hema's age 3 years ago? X plus 18 is equals to, what is Dhamini's age? X minus 6. But Hema is 3 times bigger than Dhamini, na? So I have written 3 into X minus 6. Hope you all understood, isn't it? You can see here, Hema's age 6 years ago, 6 years ago, Hema's age, that is X plus 18, was 3 times is equals to, was, that is equals to, thrice, that is 3 times of as old as Dhamini. So before 6 years, Dhamini's age was X minus 6. Now solving this equation, so X plus 18 is equals to, this first bracket we have to remove, 3 into X and 3 into 6, 3 into X, 3X minus 3, 6 are 18, am I right? Now again we need to take the like terms. So here plus 3x, here also we have 1x, so 1 is smaller. I have to remove 1x here. So subtract on both sides. So 1x minus 1x plus 18 equals to 3x minus 1x minus 18, isn't it? 3, 6 are 18. Now, plus 1x minus 1x will become 0. What is the remaining one? That is 18 is equals to 3x. Here you can see these both are like terms. 3x minus 1x is 2x. Isn't it? So here I'll get minus 18. Again, we have to keep the variable and remaining thing we have to remove. So here minus 18 is there. We have to remove this by adding plus 18. Adding 18 on both sides. Isn't it? So 18 plus 18 is equals to 2x. Minus 18 plus 18 plus 18 minus 18 will become 0. 18 plus 18 is 36. Isn't it? Here we'll get 2x. If I write in order, we can write directly in an order. These both the values are equal only now. So here I will write 2x first, and after I will write 3x. Now 2 is been multiplying here, so I have to use multiplicative inverse. So divide 2 on both sides. So 2x by 2 is equals to 36 divided by 2. So 2 by 2 is 1. If I divide 36 by 2, 2 ones are 2. 2 8s are 16, isn't it? So how much I have got x value? I have got x value as, therefore I have got x is equals to how much? 18. X value I have got as 18. Now what I want to do? I want to find the present ages of, I need to find the present ages of Dhamini and Hema, isn't it? Directly in the place of x, I will be substituting that. Am I right? So here x is equals to, what is x we have got? 18. So Dhamini's age is 18. And what about Hema's age? 18 plus 24. In the place of x, we are taking 18. Why? We have got here. So if I add this both, 20, 30, 42. 42 years. Isn't it? So what is the age of, present age of Dhamini? 18 years. What is the present age of Hema? 42 years. If you subtract this both, again you will be getting 24. Why? Why? Because Hema is 24 years bigger than Dhamini, or elder than Dhamini. So Dhamini's age is 18 years and Hema's age is 42 years. So this is how you can find the ages. As I have told you, word problems based upon the ages is very, very important. You will be getting further in your competitive exams. Whenever you are going to your higher sections, whenever you want to read, you want to go for higher section, if you want to do government exams, if you want to write the government exams, or you want to do anything, if you want to write any internal exams or external exams, okay, that is competitive exams, so there you will be getting such type of questions. Okay, so remember this thing. You just convert that in a box so that you can understand it easily. Isn't it? Now coming to next question. Let us do one more question. Isn't it? Let us see. Oh, just we have completed example 13 and example number 14, isn't it? Now let us come to example number 15. Okay, it is also very, very easy. Two digit number. Let me read once. In a two digit number, the sum of the two numbers is 8. If 18 is added to the number, its digit is reversed. 18 is added. 18 is added to the number, its digit is been reversed. What happens to its digits? It is being reversed. Okay, reversed. Then find the number. Then find the number. So let me tell you. Okay, so here we have what he had given. I will write first on the board and then I will tell what the thing he had given and what we need to do. What he had given, example 15. Given two digit number, do we know that two digit number? we don't know. Let us take that as xy. Understood? Why I am writing xy? As we are having two digits. So y is in units place and x is in tens place. Two digit number. Sum of two digits is 8. Sum of two digits is 8. Okay, sum of two digits is 8. That is sum of two digits. What is two digits? X plus Y equals to 8. Hope you all understood. Sum means what? We have to add what? Digits. What are the two digits? X, Y. So X plus Y is equals to 8. Coming to next, that is if 8 is added to the number, its digit is reversed. If 8 is added to the number, then the digits are reversed. What we need to do? We need to find the number. We need to find number. You can see here, if 8 is added to the number, what is our number? XY. So that is XY. If we add 8 to this XY, then its digits is reversed. Digits are been reversed. It means it will become YX. Very, very important question. Okay. So let me explain one more time what he had given in the question. He had given two digit number. So let us assume 54. 54 is a number. So is this a two digit number? Yes, absolutely. This is units place. This is in tens place, isn't it? Ones place and tens place. This is a two digit number. So as we don't know the two digit number, so this one I am taking as X and this one I am taking as Y. Because of that reason I have written as XY. Hope you all understood, isn't it? XY is a two digit number. So if we are reading this as 54, then we can read this as XTY. Why? Because X is in tens place and Y is in ones place. You just remember like that. XTY. X is in tens place and Y is in ones place. So this is a two digit number. Okay, we can't read like that, but for only remembering purpose I am telling you. Next one, what sum of digits is 8? First units digit is Y and tens digit is X. So if we add these both the digits, that is X plus Y, then we are getting as 8, as we are telling the said in the question. Sum of two digits is 8, that is X plus Y. If we do, we are getting the answer as 8. Now similarly, if we add 8 to the number, what is that number? XY. If we add 8 to that number, then the digits are reversed. It means that we are having the number 54. If I reverse the digits, it means units place is going to tens place and tens place is going to units place. If I reverse the digits, what happens? It will become 45, isn't it? 45. Here, can I write this? You have already discussed this about in fifth class. Can I write this as 50 plus 4 and this as 40 plus 5? Yes, of course. Why we are writing such? This is called as expansion form, expanded form. Why? As 4 is in ones place, it will be 4. As 5 is in tens place, it can be written as 50. If I add this 50 plus 4, I am getting 54. So this is the expansion form, isn't it? So this thing you have to remember, okay? Now coming to the point, what we need to do from here, as we know x plus y is equals to 8. Can I write y in terms of x? Can I write this as, okay, 8 minus x? How I am writing here? X is been added. I am subtracting. So here I am getting minus x. Why? If I add x and y, I am getting 8. If I subtract x from 8, can I get y value? Yes, absolutely. Isn't it? Then what the number will become? Therefore, the number is, number is in the place of x, it is x only, but in the place of y, how I can write? 8 minus x. So this is our required number, isn't it? So you can see, okay, 8 minus x, this is the value of y. This is in units, this is in units place and this is in tens place. Can I write this as 10x plus 8 minus x? Can I? Why I'm writing? Just now I have told you 54 can be written as 50 plus 4. Why? As 5 lies in the tens place. So can I write x as in a tens place? So can I write 10x? And this is in ones place, plus 8 minus x. Okay, if I reverse the digit, reverse of the digit, reverse of digits, what is the reverse of digits? 8 minus x will come first and last x we are getting, isn't it? This is now in tens place. So can I write 10 into 8 minus x plus x? So if I multiply 10 into 8, 80 minus 10 into x, 10x plus x. So on simplifying this, 10x minus x, I'll be getting 9x plus 8. And here I'll be getting, okay, minus 9x. So 80 minus 9x. Am I right? Now coming to this condition, which condition? 8 is added to. Here we have the condition. So the number what we have got here, 9x plus 8, again we have plus 8 here, and reverse digit number, what do we call here? What do we get here? 80 minus 9x. So if I simplify, 9x plus 16 is equals to, okay, 80 minus 9x. Now you know how to solve. You have to send this here. How we will? Here we have minus, we are been adding with 9x. So 9x plus 16 is equals to 80, plus 9x minus 9x will become 0. You already know about this. Again here we have plus 16, so we are removing this by minus 16, isn't it? So 9x plus 9x, 18x plus 16 minus 16 will become 0 here. So 80 minus 16, so 18x is equals to 80 minus 16. 10 minus 6 is 4, am I right? 7 minus 1 is 6. So x is equal to 64 divided by 18. Is it correct or not? 64 divided by 18. I think we have did it. Something mistake here. We'll be getting 90 here. What the number we have got? The number we have got in the question is 80 minus 9x. He had taken that number, 80 minus 9x. plus, I have taken wrong here. In the question he said if 18 is added, I am writing only 8 as added. If the number is 18, if 18 is added to the number, 18 19 20 26, I am getting here 26. So removing 26 on both sides, so here I'll get minus 26, isn't it? So on solving you'll be getting the answer. Hope you all understood what, how we have to do. Okay, just I have written in the place of adding 18, okay, in the place of 18 I have taken 8, so I'm here wrong. Okay, so this is the thing what